Hello guys, I hope you are all doing well. In this video, we are going to make our first program in C programming language. So open up your text editor and let's begin. Before writing the code, create a file with any name with the extension of .c. For example, the name of our file, let's say, is example.c. Right, inside it, first of all, write hash include studio dot h. Right, after that write int main and then parenthesis, then curly braces, this is opening curly braces, and inside it write printf, and we will write here hello programs. And that's all. Note that printf is in lowercase. This is our first program. Okay. Now compile this file and run this program. In the output screen, you will see the output as hello programs. Right. Now we have our program and its output. This is our output of our program. Okay. So what exactly happened here? First of all, we write hash include studio.h. Now what happened with this line, right? This hash is actually a preprocessor directive, right? Now what is a preprocessor directive? Basically, with preprocessor directive, we are indicating that we want to communicate with our preprocessor and to tell him that we want to execute some instruction before actual compilation happens. Now what instruction is written after the hash? Okay, so I want my preprocessor to execute an instruction, and the name of our instruction is include. Now what is preprocessor? Basically, in entire build process of our program up to the output, there are various steps, and one such step is preprocessing, which is done by our preprocessor. And this is one of the many steps in our build process. Okay, so hash means we are telling our preprocessor, then include means to include a file, and studio.h is the name of our file, right? And these files are also known as the header files with the extension of .h. Then we have main function. Now basically the execution of our program start from the main, okay, and integer is the value which will be returning back to who is calling our main function. Basically the some value will be returned to our operating system, right? So this is about the main, that the execution of our program start from its body, from the body of our main function. Now here is the printf. Basically printf is also a function, and every function provides us some sort of functionality. Okay, there are basically two type of function. One is built-in and other is custom. Custom functions are made by us and built-in functions are provided by our compiler. So basically this is our built-in function. Built-in function. And since this is our built-in function, it is providing us the functionality to print something on the screen. Okay, so whatever I am writing here will be shown in our output screen, right? For example, if I write here hello and with additional o, then after compiling and run, it will give me output as hello extra o and then programs. And this all, for example, preprocessor directive, header files, and main function, built-in function, custom function will be described in the upcoming videos in a great detail. This is just a brief introduction what is going behind the scene. Okay, now let's make another program in which we will print two lines. So first of all, we will write, let's say, printf, and then we will write hello world, right? And then in the next printf we can write hello programming, right? Then we will compile it and run it in our output. The output will be shown, will be hello world, and in the same line it will be hello programming, right? But let's say that I want to print hello programming from the next line. Now what should I do? I should write here a special character which is the slash n, okay, slash n. Now slash n is the special character which will bring our cursor to the next line. For example, here if we write the same program with the slash n, then first of all hello world will be printed and then it will encounter slash n. So instead of cursor being here, our cursor will be in this location, okay? And now we are printing hello programming. So now it will print here hello programming, right? So basically slash n is a line break, okay? Here slash n will be our line break, okay? So this is our first program in which we had learned about how to print the sentences in C programming language. Now you should try to make your own custom sentences in C language and try to play around with it, okay? So that's all for today, guys. I hope you like the video. If you have any doubt, please comment it down. Thanks for watching and I hope to see you in the next video.